Poetry Talks. I'm Sophie from Miss Whitty's class.
And I'm Harper from Mrs. Davis's class.
Welcome to this edition of WPTE.
What an amazing week we had.
We had a great Valentine's Day and we have President's Day coming up.
Hey, do you want to hear a joke?
Sure, I love jokes.
Why is it impossible to learn the alphabet at sea?
I don't know. Why?
Because you'll get lost at sea.
That's so funny. I'm so hungry. What's for lunch today?
Today's lunch is chicken nuggets and breadsticks. Salad is chicken Caesar salad.
Other options are hummus plate and PB&J.
Sounds so good.
Harper, is anyone celebrating a birthday at Prairie Trace today?
Yes, today's birthday are Griffin Wiegand, Liam Burgess, and William Linhart Miller.
Birthdays over the weekend is Adrian Perella.
Happy birthday!
Go down to the office to claim your birthday treats.
Next up is Maggie with weather. What can we expect this weekend?
Hello, Prairie Trace Hawks. This is Margaret from Miss Whitty's class here with weather. Today, there is a high of 31 and a low of 21 with a 3% chance of rain. Sounds like a nice day to go play outside. Make sure to bring a coat. Saturday, there will be a high of 46 and a low of 35 with a 1% chance of rain. Sounds like there will be no rain, so go get some exercise and play outside. Sunday, there will be a high of 51 and a low of 41 with a 6% chance of rain. Sounds like this weekend will be very nice. Make sure to play outside a lot. Can you believe this amazing weather we're having for February? I'm definitely going to take advantage. Thanks for tuning in for the weather. Now back to the studio with Sophie and Harper.
Thanks, Maggie. It looks like a great weekend to play outside.
Next up, we have Will with sports.
Hi, I'm Will from Mrs. Davis's class, and I'm here this week with sports. Tonight's men's basketball team is home against Warren Central. Tip-off is at 7:30. Tomorrow, number 14-ranked IU men's basketball is home against Illinois. Tip-off is at 12 o'clock. The Hoosiers are hoping to continue their recent surge. And on Sunday, the number 2-ranked Hoosiers face off against Purdue in Bloomington. Tip-off is at noon. Early projections look like it'll be a sold-out crowd for the Hoosiers. The number 3-ranked Purdue men's basketball is home against Ohio State on Sunday at 1 o'clock. Tomorrow, Notre Dame men's basketball is at Virginia at noon. Tomorrow as well, Ball State men's basketball is at West Michigan. Tip-off is at 2:30. On Sunday, Butler hosts for Georgetown. Tip-off is at 3 o'clock. Butler is hoping to build up upon their win against their rival Xavier last weekend. Also, on last Sunday, Super Bowl 57 was hosted in Arizona. In the end, the Kansas City Chiefs beat the Philadelphia Eagles 38-35. So that wraps up the NFL games for this season, but the NFL news is far from over. The Colts have officially hired the Eagles offensive coordinator Shane Steichen as their new head coach. Colts fans are hoping with the help of some early draft picks, he can coach the team back into the playoffs. And now to the NBA. Last week, LeBron James broke the league's all-time scoring record. This was previously held by Kareem Abdul-Jabbar for almost four decades. And finally, the Pacers will travel to Orlando to take on the Magic. Tip-off is at 7. That's all for this week's sports, and now it's time to head back to Harper and Sophie in the studio.
Good luck to all our Indiana teams!
Rithiksha is up next with National Days.
Let's see what National Days we can celebrate today.
Hello, Prairie Trace Hawks. This is Rithiksha from Miss Woody's class. Today I'm here to talk about the National Days. Today's National Day is Random Acts of Kindness Day. It is celebrated by individuals, groups, and organizations nationwide to encourage acts of kindness. The movement of Random Acts of Kindness inspires people every day. I'm definitely going to be spreading some kindness around my community today. Tomorrow's National Day is National Eat Ice Cream for Breakfast Day. This day was created to commemorate the 9 wonderful years of the bright soul that was Malia Grace, born on February 18, 2001. Malia, who passed away after a long fight with cancer on December 7, 2010, and also was an inspiration to everyone around her. I certainly will be eating chocolate ice cream for breakfast. Sunday's National Day is National Tug of War Day. Tug of War has grown up from the days of your youth. In addition to having its own holiday, Tug of War has national and international federations that sponsor worldwide tournaments. Are you going to play tug-of-war with your friends and family? I sure am. This is Ritiksha from Miss Whitty's class. Now back to the studio with Sophie and Harper.
Thank you, Ritiksha.
Now do you know what time it is?
No, what?
Time for Mackenzie and Avi
with Did You Know?
Hello, Prairie Trace Hawks. This is Mackenzie from Miss Whitty's class.
And Avi from Mrs. Davis's class.
With Did You Know?
Did you know the Mona Lisa has no eyebrows?
No, but did you know that only humans can blush?
I didn't, but did you know that a cow gives nearly 200,000 glasses of milk in a lifetime?
No, but did you know that elephants are the only animal that can't jump?
No, but guess what? A shrimp's heart is in its head.
Wow, but did you know that axolotls can regenerate body parts?
No, but did you know that there's an entire holiday dedicated to what would happen if dogs and cats had opposable thumbs?
Well, did you know that 10% of people dream in only black and white?
No, but did you know that Did You Know is over?
No, I didn't, but now I do.
Now back to Sophie and Harper
in the studio.
Wow, did you know all that amazing stuff?
Nope, but now I do.
Do you know Miss Lugerman and her dog?
Of course I do.
Well, next up we have David and Miss Lugerman with Pets on the Prairie.
Hello, Prairie Trace Hawks. Today, I am David with Mrs. Lugerman here with another adorable animal named Blue.
What's Blue's breed?
Blue is a golden retriever.
Cool. How old is Blue?
Blue is like 2 months old, like 12 weeks.
Wow. What is Blue's favorite food?
Blue loves treats. We haven't really given him many treats, but we think that he's going to like peanut butter the best, and he gets that treat tonight for the first time.
Can he do any tricks?
He can do tricks. I'm not sure if we'll do them right now, but we can try. Okay. He's sitting. Blue sit. Blue lay down. Good job. And then he can stay and leave treats too. So
nice.
I'm pretty impressed.
Do you have any funny stories?
Well, yesterday at daycare, he made his first Valentine's and he painted a heart and it's now hanging on my fridge. But no funny stories yet.
Aw, that was so, that's so cute. Thank you, Mrs. Lugman and Blue. Now back to the studio.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Well, the party was nice, the party was pumping.
Hey, yeah. V-I-O.
And everybody having a ball.
Hey, hey. V-I-O.
Until the fellas start the name calling.
V-I-O.
And the girls respond to the call. I have a pull my shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
I see the dance people had a falcon. So Billy Bongers get out. Get back, Gruffy. Bass Gruffy. Get back, you flea infested mongrel. I tell myself I'm a no get angry.
Hey, yeah, V-I-O.
To where the girls calling them canine.
Hey,
V-I-O. But they tell me, hey man, start up the party.
V-I-O.
You put a woman in front and a man behind. I have a woman shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Say, I told you. Is nothing if he don't have a bone.
Oh, doggy, hold your bone. Oh, doggy, hold your bone.
A doggy is nothing if he don't have a bone.
Oh, doggy, hold your bone. Oh, doggy, hold it. Hold it.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
I see the dance people had a ball, cause Billy Bongers get out. Get back, Gruffy, Bass Gruffy, get back, you flea infested mongrel.
Well, if I am a dog, the party is on. I gotta get my groove on, got my mind, I'm gone. Do you see the rays coming from my eye? Walking through the place, the Digimon is breaking them down. Me and my white socks, short, dealing, can't see color. Any color of you, I think I knew, that's why they call me Pitbull. Cause I'm the man of the land, when they see me, they say, ooh.
Thanks, David and Mrs. Lugman.
Blue is so cute.
Over to Izzy with current events.
Hi, I'm Izzy, and welcome to current events. To start off, some builders are getting together to build the first ever two-story 3D printed house. I wonder who will live there. To flip it off, in eastern Ohio, residents have been on edge for over a week following an explosive train derailment and a toxic chemical leak. Evacuation orders have been lifted and the all-clear has been given in East Palestine, a small community with a population of about 5,000 on the Pennsylvania border, but it's still a very scary situation. And to finish off, last week on the 7th of February, a massive earthquake struck southern Turkey and northern Syria, demolishing cities, stealing lives of over 35,000 people, and injuring thousands more. Let's hope all the families that live there are in good health. Thanks for tuning in. Now back to Sophie and Harper in the studio.
Thanks, Izzy, for all those current events.
Next up, we have Dylan with Word of the Week.
Hi, I'm Dylan from Miss Davis's class, and I'm here with today's Word of the Week. This week's word is sustainable. Sustainable means to able to continue or being kept up over time. Now I'll use sustainable in a sentence. The materials we used to build the tent were sustainable and they lasted a long time through harsh weather conditions. Let's play a game. I'm gonna say three synonyms or antonyms of the word sustainable. If it's a synonym, stand up. If it's an antonym, sit down. Remember, a synonym is when it has the same meaning of a word. An antonym is when it has the opposite meaning of a word. The first word is continuous. You should be standing. The second word is temporary. You should be sitting down. My final word is unending. You should be standing. Great job. Unfortunately, we are out of time, but thanks for tuning in. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, Dylan, for that amazing word. We can help use our sustainable resources to help our planet.
Next up is Nate with Person of the Week.
The Person of the Week this week is Harriet Tubman. Her people called her the Moses of her people because she saved so many of her people's lives. Her real name was Arminita Ross, which she later changed to Harriet Tubman. She was a conductor of the Underground Railroad, which helped people get out of slavery. This was not actually underground or an actual railroad. It was just a path through America that the enslaved people could stay safe. She also worked as a scout, a spy, and a guerrilla soldier, and a nurse for the Union Army during the Civil War. This helped free the enslaved people, and she had 8 siblings who helped her achieve these goals. Thanks for tuning in. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, Nate. I learned a lot about Harriet Tubman.
Now it's time with Brooklyn with Leadership Skills this month. Let's see how we can listen before we speak.
Hello, Preacher Socks. This is Brooklyn from Miss Whitty's class. This month's leadership skill is think before you speak. You could take a breath before yelling at your sibling. Take a second and think with your class how you can think before you speak. Now I'm going to interview 2 kids from Miss Henry's class.
Hello, Preacher Socks. I'm here with Nicholas to ask him some questions. How can you spread kindness to think before you speak at school?
So you can spread kindness so people can finish their conversation, so you can make an easy conclusion for other people.
Wow, that's a great answer. Hi, I'm here with Lola to ask her some questions. How can you spread kindness around school to think before you speak.
You can spread kindness by, it helps you listen to other people's conversations and you can engage with them more and become better friends.
Why is it important to think before you speak?
It's important because you can be a kinder friend and you will also listen a lot better.
Why is it important to think before you speak?
If your teacher was giving examples and you blurred out, then you wouldn't know the, you wouldn't know what she was telling you.
Yeah.
So you'd know the answers.
Thanks for tuning in. Now back to Sophie and Harper in the studio.
Thanks, Brooklyn. I love to listen before I speak, too.
Next up is Helen and Miss Catchman with Teacher Feature.
Hello, Patriots Hawks. This is Helen from Mrs. Whitty's class with Mrs. Catchman. Mrs. Catchman, is it okay if I ask you some questions?
Of course.
Okay, how many years have you been teaching here for?
So this is my second year as a classroom teacher, but it's my fourth year in the building. I was a resource IA for a year, and then I did my student teaching in first grade here as well.
Do you have any pets?
I do. I have one dog. His name is Arlo. He's my child. I love him. He is a hoot.
What would you be if you weren't a teacher?
So if I wasn't a teacher and everything could be a perfect world, I would be a stay-at-home dog mom and just take care of my dog all day. Take him for walks, play with him, snuggle with him, and nothing else.
Okay. What is your favorite Starbucks drink?
Right now, it's the pistachio cold brew, but on a regular week, I do the vanilla cold brew.
What did you think you were going to be when you were younger?
So growing up, I always wanted to be a vet. I actually went to Purdue for a year of pre-vet school. It was really hard. And so then I switched into teaching, which was better. I'm actually allergic to cats, so I don't think my vet life would have worked out for me anyway.
Okay. Do you have any favorite books?
I can't think of one specifically, but any type of thriller, mystery, something that keeps me on my toes. I like any type of book that's like that.
What do you do on your free time?
I hang out with my dog. I do a lot of spending time with Arlo, and I do like to watch. I'm really, really good at watching Netflix TV shows.
Okay.
So.
This is going to be a funny one.
Okay.
My sister's in your class.
Yes.
But what is the funniest things your kids have ever done?
I have a lot of really funny things that the kids do. Being in kindergarten, honestly, I just wish I could write a book of all of the things that they have ever said to me, because they say some of the funniest things and I'm just like, where did that come from? And it just makes my day a lot better. But I mean, I've got some break dancers in my class right now that are pretty funny. So.
What's your favorite day of the week?
Friday, because it leads up to the weekend. And Fridays are fun too. We do fun Fridays in my classroom, so they're also fun.
Do you speak another language?
I wish I did. So my mom does. She's actually from a different country, but she never taught me Spanish. So I speak English and English only.
Now back to Sophie and Harper in the studio.
Thanks, Helen and Miss Katrin.
Now it's time for Mystery Baby with Nora. I wonder who it is.
Hello, Prairie Trace Hawks. My name is Nora from Miss Davis's class. Welcome to Mystery Baby. Last week, answer was Miss Green, our amazing front office lady. And the winner last week was nobody. New Mystery Baby facts are, this person has children who attended or attend Prairie Trace. This person was on the Carmel High School gymnastics team. On the weekend, you can find this person watching lots of basketball. This is Mystery Baby, now back to the studio.
Thanks, Nora, with Mystery Baby. It's always fun, a surprise.
Now it's an important message from our ambassador team.
Good morning, Prairie Trace Hawks. This is David with PTE Ambassadors. We wanted to thank you all for participating in soccer sales at PTE. We raised $1,675.50. Wow, we know this will help with Riley kids at Riley Children's Hospital. We have our last fundraiser for Riley Children's Hospital, and it is our biggest one of the year. It's almost time for everyone's favorite PTE dance marathon. We are asking you to start fundraising for dance marathon. This will be happening on Friday afternoon on March 17th. Talk with your parents or guardian about ways you could fundraise to help raise money for the kids at Riley. We will celebrate it by having an awesome dance marathon as a school. Are you ready to see this year's dance marathon dance? Start practicing with your class now. Here we go, and don't forget to raise money for Riley. Thanks.
Are y'all ready, kids?
F-D-K!
I can't hear you!
F-D-K!
You had me down, but I got up. Already brushing off the dust. You hear my voice, you hear that sound. I got the eye of the tiger, the fire. Dancing through the fire. Cause I am a champion. And you're gonna hear me roar louder. Louder than a lion. Cause I am a champion. And you're gonna hear me roar. You're gonna hear me roar.
Just believe I'm still bejeweled. When I walk in the room, I can still make the whole place shimmer.
But you, when you dance, 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 feel the good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, 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 come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance, dance, dance. And ain't nobody leaving soon, so keep dancing.
I can't stop the feeling.
So just dance.
Wow, I make sure to practicing that dance in my classroom.
Me too. I might start doing some extra chores at home so I have more money to donate.
That's a great idea. I might have to steal it. Well, that's all for WPTE this week. I'm Sophie.
And I'm Harper.
We will end with the National Anthem Leadership Pledge in a moment of silence. Thank you for tuning in. See you on the prairie. As a Prairie Trace Elementary leader, to have a positive attitude each day. I will make good choices even when no one is looking. I will demonstrate leadership skills to make myself and my school an amazing place.